Thanks very much for that, Jack. Don't really know how I'm going to follow that one, but nonetheless, I'll see what I can come up with. Distinguished guests of no particular distinction, relatives young and old, friends, freeloaders, hanging on, gypsies, droughts, thieves, and anyone else who may have wanted in. You are all about to witness a unique event in history. Now, obviously you guys can all label yourselves as far as I'm concerned, but the very first, and no doubt last time, that my wife is going to let me speak on behalf of us. However, it is a privilege and an honour to do so. I just hope that so soon into our married life, I don't let you know. My speech today will be like a miniskirt. Long enough to cover the essentials, but short enough to hold your attention. To be honest, I didn't really know where to start, so I thought I'd troll the internet. After a couple of hours, I found some really, really good stuff. But then I remembered I was supposed to be writing a speech. Before I do really get going, there's going to be plenty of toast over the next few minutes. So everybody just make sure that you've got your glasses charged. First of all, Joe, we'd like to thank you for your kind words and good wishes. I don't want you to think of it as losing a daughter, but more like gaining another son. So let's raise a glass to Jack. It's lovely to see so many of our family and friends here today to help us celebrate the happiest day of our lives. I know that some of you have travelled a long way to be here, and that means a lot to both of us. It really wouldn't be the same without you all. There are numerous people who have made the trip from the States, but particularly I'd like to thank Fiona's brother David, and good friends of Fiona's family, Janet and Helen, who have always made the effort to both make me feel welcome and be there for Fiona on her visits to her home. Also, I'd like to say a big thank you to another of Fiona's brothers, Michael, who has left behind his children for the first time to be here today for our big day. So thanks, Michael. There are also a lot of people who couldn't make it here today for various reasons. Particularly, I'd like to raise a toast to one of Fiona's best friends, who also attended the ceremony via the modern technology of Skype, as we all know. So, raise a glass to Hazel. Hazel. Also, at this time, I'd like to propose a toast to those who could not be with us, but who surely would have taken great delight in this wonderful day. To Fiona's mother, Alison, and also to my grandma, Lily. Cheers. Very difficult when two families come together, but we have been extremely lucky. Fiona's family have welcomed me into their family, and my family have welcomed Fiona into ours. We all get on so well, which is really a rare thing. So, again, I'd like to raise a toast to both families who really couldn't be more suited to one another. Cheers. My mum and dad have helped me enormously over the years, and I'm sure my wife will agree that our time in South Africa, when the twins were first born, would have been so much less manageable had my mum not come out. Well, That's for Dan. I'd just like to ask everyone to raise your glasses and join me in a toast to the bridesmaids, bridesman, and flower girls, ushers and page boy. Cheers. Cheers. I've known Dave, my best man, for 17 years now. And throughout that time, he has been there for me when it matters. And he's always ready with an encouraging word and a welcome bottle of beer or two when needed. For example, last night. Which happens to be the same time when I was writing the speech. So.
Last night this morning.
I'd also like to thank him for all his help in organising the stag do, which I think all who were involved in would agree was a truly momentous occasion, particularly with some of the injuries sustained during the paintball incident. But most importantly, I'd like to thank him for being a true friend. However, there is something that I need to make you aware of. Dave suffers from a strange condition that occasionally causes him to drift in and out of weird, strange flights of fantasy. Anyway, it's only right that I advise you all of this ahead of his speech. As I say, he is a true friend, and I wouldn't want you to go upsetting him. So if you could bear with him, even join with him on his journey of make-believe, I really would appreciate it. Finally, I would like to thank my wife. I think I'm going to enjoy getting used to saying that. For agreeing to marry me and for making me the happiest man in the world. I think you'll agree that she looks absolutely gorgeous today. And when she walked up the aisle, she took my breath away. Fiona, I love you in so many ways and for so many reasons. You know me and understand me like no one else ever could. You make me laugh so hard and smile so often. You have a way of bringing out the very best in me. But mostly because you're my very best friend, my soulmate. I love you with all my heart. Thank you for marrying me and making me the happiest man alive. And for loving me as much as I love you. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand and raise your glasses to my beautiful wife, Fiona.